Hi, class. This is the conclusion to my Bison project here. And I'm not going to do much of a voiceover, just here and there. This has been speeded up to 1.5 times, unlike twice, like the last one. I thought that was a little bit too fast. And my restriction is to keep this under 15 minutes because of the YouTube length. So here, the clay has dried out enough that I can start to use more scrapey tools and do more precise work, which is kind of what I'm doing here. I'm kind of shifting over to details. So while the basic shape of this is a bison head, or sort of, probably more other kind of maybe more humanistic elements come into play in terms of the details. Thank you. Okay, I'm gonna jump in here and tell you what I'm about to do here. The forehead has seems to me to be kind of breaking apart, and it's a little getting very thin. So I'm slipping and scoring and adding some more clay to this side and also to the inside where I can reach, because I really need it to be thicker here. Thank you. So at this point, when the clay reaches a certain hardness, it becomes workable with rasps rather than the cheese grater type tools that I've been using, because at this point it won't clog the rasps up. And the rasps give you actually, because they come in a greater variety of shapes, they give you greater possibilities for shaping. And here I'm also taking a little bit of sunscreen and starting to soften up some of the edges. Getting close to the end here, so I'm going to start doing a little burnishing to highlight some of the leading edges and high spots with a piece of plastic and with a little hard stone. And so this is pretty well it. This is going on the drying rack, and it's going to get fired pretty soon, and then maybe I'll do another video of that. So there it is, and good luck with your projects.